Today we discuss about some instrument which is used for carpentry shop. This is steel rule, which is measuring instrument. This is tenon saw, which is cut is a straight line of a job. This is rip saw, which is used along the fiber of a wood. This is a wood. The fiber direction is this line. When we need to cut this direction, then we used the rip saw. And this is cross cut saw, which is used cutting across the wooden fiber. This is the wood piece. The fiber direction is this direction, and we need to cut off this direction. Then we use this saw. Okay. This is called marking gauge. It is made by wooden, and this one made by metal. Both are marking gauge. This is chisel. It's called farmer chisel, bevel edge farmer chisel. This edge is slight bevel edge, and this portion is flat. This is called bevel edge farmer chisel. And this is mortise chisel. It's called mortise chisel. When we need to this type of cut, we used this chisel, mortise chisel, for this type of shape. This is called rasp file. Rasp file, its teeth is too much bigger than other files. This file is used for only for soft material like wood, rubber, fiber. This is flat rasp file, and this is half round rasp file. Half round rasp file. And this is called mallet. It is used for striking. We used for the chiseling purpose. Okay. This is called tri square. It is used for checking the 90 degree angle like this. Dear student, this is called cross half lap joint. Cross half lap joint. This has two parts. Its two parts are same. Now I do this one of part from this wooden piece. A single part. How we cut this? At first we need to 90 degree angle of two surface and plane. It's plane. This is called jack plane. Iron jack plane. It is used for surface planing of a wooden job. Now this surface is complete. Then we need to same type of surface of side plane. Now we check it the angle of 90 degree. It's perfect. It's 90 degree. No light passes. Okay. Then we need to mark this wooden piece. This wooden piece is measured by 36 mm. With this 36 mm, we need to it 30 mm. Now, follow it. How the marking gauge is setting. This pin is distance from this surface 30 mm. We set it 30 mm. Okay. Now we mark this line. Now this line is already marking. We just darkening the line by a pencil. Now this portion is removing by the jack plane. Now this is finished at 30 mm and check this 90 degree angle. Okay. Now three sides is complete. One side is due. This surface is we need to plane. So it is marking line 30 mm. This wood piece is ready. All sides are 30 mm. Okay. Then we have to cut, we need to cut this type of shape, which is associated center. Okay, the wooden piece is length 120 mm. The center line is 60 mm. Then we mark this at 60 mm point. Six, that means 60 mm point. Then this width is 30 mm. We need to mark the line of total 30 mm. So our center is 60 mm. Then both sides are marking 15 mm. Left side 15 and right side 15. Okay. It has 3 point. 1, this is center line, 2, and this is side line, 3. Now we mark the line to help by a tri square. See, one line, one side. Look at this 30 mm gap of center. Now it is 30 mm. This depth is just half of the thickness, so it is 30 mm, half of the 15 mm. We set the marking gauge at 15 mm. Now it's 15 mm. Okay, we mark at this just a single line. Now we cut. Okay. Now we already know the straight line is cutting by tenon saw, so we used this tenon saw for cutting a straight line. It's cutting by tenon saw. After cutting, this line may be shown. Now we cut
depth this line up to this line. Okay. Now we use the former chisel and mallet to remove the middle portion. Now this is ready to join the cross applap joint. This is same shape, size is difference, but this two type wooden piece is joined this type, which is called cross applap joint. Okay, thickness is same, and it is, this is called lapping, and this lapping shape is cross, so it's called cross half lap joint. Thank you.